Stop it if it is preheated within minutes. That was the questions raised by Nikita Alexandrov. Thank you very much, Nikita Alexandrov. Question number two by Norman Cook, again from ICCF. It has been rumored that Difkalion has done monoisotopic experiments using their nickel hydrogen system, and that all of the nickel isotopes except nickel 61 produced excess heat. Is that true? Were the other isotopes of nickel equally capable of producing cold fusion effects? This is not a rumor, this has been announced already to the people at following CNMS, the forum of the researchers of this section. And you are going to hear more about that during Yom Kim's presentation in 2 days in ICCF, where there is a very big good explanation. I can, even though I'm not going to give you, yet this is not a rumor, yes, we have done it. Now I'm going to say why we were inspired to do it. There was no specific reasons to doing that unless we had to answer a business question. In the beginning, I was asked from my management to answer to a question how I was expecting to, how much I was expecting to be the cost of the production of the product, what would be the cost of the production line, and what would be the cost for maintenance. At that moment, there were rumors that only nickel 62 or 64 could participate in the reaction. If that was the case, then the cost of the maintenance would be higher. So we ran several experiments using monoisotopic crystals, prepared all the same way, treated all the same way, and we surprisingly found out that only nickel 61 could not give any excess heat. But when I'm saying none, zero. All other isotopes produced almost the same results. No significant differences there. You can hear more about that and why this is expected for non-physics following Yong Kim's presentation next Thursday. Question number three from Ed Bell. Hi, Ed. Have you built any reactor with closed primary cooling loops? If so, how many have you made in the last 6 months? As I said in the beginning of the presentation, we are building now our release 6 reactor, 6th generation reactor, lab prototype. Actually, this very next one is going to use a primary loop to cool the reactor, which we are going to use thermal oil. And this exchange then the heat power through an external heat exchanger for any measurement that we want to do. We are not ready to announce or to present this as far as we're still testing components and performance. Typically, this is the same reactor like this one. It's much lighter. We know what type of problems we are not expecting to have right now. We didn't know that when we were building this apparatus. That is why it is 8.5 kilograms. The next one is lighter. And of course, the next generation will have been designed for maximum performance. That release 5 reactor was designed for us to understand how we can control it and how we can manage it. Number question, and this is the last from ICCF, coming from Steve Jones. What products have you looked for that may help us understand what you're seeing? Have you looked for tritium, helium, helium-3, helium-4, gammas, X-rays, RF. Any correlated products or radiation would be very helpful. Thank you for your work. We're going to present the gamma emissions that we measure correlated with thermal signals, thermal anomalies in isoparabolic experiments. Some of them, sometime series, are going to be presented by Yong Kim in 2 days. Of course, we reported last year in ICCM 17 about the transmutation that we see. We haven't seen any emissions that we have to report right now. There will be more announcements and papers related with all these. Also, it is important to say that we have observed something we were not expecting. Huge magnetic anomalies. This reactor today is shielded with Faraday cages, so that will allow us to run our electronics this device I'm using to read the questions, etc. And this is very important. This still is going to be presented by Hyung Kim in the paper in 2 days in ICCF. These were the four questions raised by ICCF. If more are coming from ICCF, I will be happy to answer them by closing this broadcasting in some hours. Two more questions that came before. One I answered already, I will repeat, is why are we using argon and not helium in our control tests? I